Staats. I'm the commanding general for the 75th Innovation Command, and I wanted to do this introduction for our App Development Course 101 today. I'm going to just talk about what the outline for this is. I'm going to talk about why we're doing the course. I'm going to talk about how the classes are organized. And then I'm just going to talk a little philosophically about app development. So the first thing to note is that this course is one of three that we're offering. This is App Development 101. It uses a very, very simple app development process and kit that's been developed by MIT. It's been used by literally hundreds of thousands of people across the world to write, no kidding, working apps. Our second course, the 102 course, won't be required for everybody. It is a introduction to object-oriented programming. The 103, which is Java for app development. You need to understand the ins and outs of methods and sources, shared data, and object-oriented programming in general to get full use out of the Java language and use it in developing really good apps. So why did we do this course? This is a second iteration of the course. We put the course together for several reasons, and they're related to our principles. First and foremost, we wanted to support Army Futures Command. Since we developed our course, they have put together something called the Software Factory, which is designed to teach cadres of soldiers how to do app development and then send them out in groups to the force to help solve real-world problems in real time out in our field armies. From a parent principle standpoint, be professional. This is really an important part of our kit bag if we're going to support Army Futures Command. Secondly, from a Stafford principle standpoint, developing apps is a very creative activity, and it supports our third principle, the Peterson principle, which is have fun. I can tell you that people that took the course originally, the version one of this course, have gone on to learn more about app development on their own. Many of them have written apps for their friends and family, and they're really, really enjoying what they learned in the course and then applying and learning more about it. I want to talk a little bit about the course itself. I think it's important for folks to understand that app development is way less daunting than it seems. That's why we put this App 101 course together. The universal response when we did the survey at the end of the course was that everybody agreed that their idea of what it took to develop an app before they took the course was that it was way harder and more complicated than the course revealed it to be. If we're honest, we didn't go into each and every detail in app development, and you can make it very, very complicated, and you can spend a lot of resources developing an app. On the other hand, if you want to do something relatively simple, once you have gone through this 101 course, you'll be able to knock out an app in probably less than an hour to do basic, kind of basic things, whether that's developing a messaging tool for your friends and family, whether that is something that helps you integrate location, identification, maps, mark things on a map, whether that's helping you take notes, or even just putting together a simple game, you will find that it's relatively simple to do. So how is this class organized? Well, every class is going to start off with an introductory video. Those videos are usually relatively short, and they're going to talk about the key learning objectives in that particular class. Then there's going to be the practical exercise. We'll be using the MIT App Inventor, and usually those take an hour or two max. For the end of class group project, you probably will end up spending 8 to 16 hours on that. And then finally, we have live office hours where you'll be able to interact in real time with an instructor, ask your questions, find solutions to any vexing problems, get advice, etc. So what are some key things you're going to get out of this? You're going to learn more about how to do symbolic logic, learn about loops and counting and rules, you'll learn about sensor inputs and databases. You learn about authentication and identity. And all those things you're going to learn in this course. So I'm very, very proud of the great job that my fellow instructor team have done in putting this together. I think you're really, really going to enjoy the course. And I believe that this is going to be the beginning of a journey that will probably not end throughout your professional career. So enjoy the course. And we look forward to any feedback you have for us. Thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to share something special with you. Have a great day.